Hello and welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you haven't yet hit the subscribe button, please remember to do so now. If you also haven't checked out our podcast with Cassie Thorpe, head over, click onto that one. It will be in the corner somewhere, either of these two corners. And yeah, go and check it out. It's about an hour to an hour and a half long of just literally just talking about designer, everything luxury. So podcasts are great for just listening to while you're doing something else. So if you've got some work to do, just whack it on in the background. If you're traveling somewhere, just put it on in your car. If you're doing some chores around the house, it's just great to listen to because you can multitask with them. And that's why we're doing them, because we just want you to hear all things luxury, what you enjoy listening about while you're doing something else. So yeah, head over, listen to that. And let me know in the comment section what you think of it. What we're gonna be doing in this video is reviewing the Alexander McQueen Bubble Sole sneaker. In front of me, and I'm just going to start off with saying it's not great. It personally, I don't like it. What I'm going to do is review the shoe, tell you about it, and then give my personal opinion on it. So obviously the Alexander McQueen Bubble Sole sneaker, it's got the exact same upper as your regular Alexander McQueen's. So you've got the calfskin leather with the calfskin tab, and then you've got this narrow lace set with the chunky laces and these perforated holes in the middle of the shoe. Exactly the same as the other Alexander McQueen sneaker. When you move on to the midsole, that's when it starts to change up a bit. You've got this clear, transparent bubble midsole, but it's not 100% air. So if you know your Nike Air Maxes, they're air all the way through, 100% air. These aren't. These have got like a big plastic chunk in the middle of the shoe going right the way around, and the bubble, the air bit, is just around the side of the shoe. When you flip it onto the outer sole, it's the exact same outer sole as the regular Alexander McQueen, except where the safari print is, it's the clear midsole, so you can see right up into the sole. It's same size, so you've got 2 inches extra of height, so it's good for those people who want to look a bit taller. It's actually a very narrow shoe. It's only when you add this midsole to it, it then becomes really chunky. Because it's got plastic within the middle of the midsole, and because they've used this really thick, durable, clear midsole, it means the shoe's really heavy. So these now weigh more than a Balenciaga Triple S, so about just over £3. And that's really heavy for a shoe. And that was the first thing I noticed when I picked them up. They were a really, really heavy shoe. Okay, so that is basically the shoe. So I'm just gonna tell you why I don't like them. And the white clear midsole, it's made of rubber. So that means when you knock them together, they create scratches. And because it's rubber, you can't do anything to like resurrect the scratch. You can't make it look like the scratch hasn't been there. Once you've scratched them, that's it. Also, another thing is they're really heavy, and for a small shoe than your Triple S, you expect the Triple S to be heavy. You don't expect a shoe like this to be as heavy as they are. Like, when you pick them up, it will be like, wow, why are they that heavy? Another thing, yes, they are a really durable, really thick midsole, but they do scratch, and if you pop them, your shoes are over. So say that you stand on a pin, a nail, whatever, the shoes are ruined. If you do that with your other Alexander McQueens, because they're not a bubble sole, your shoes aren't ruined. You can step on anything and they won't be wrecked. But with these, it's just something I've always been skeptical with about bubble shoes. If you pop them, your shoes are ruined. And over time, because it's only air inside, they are gonna, less air is gonna be there. Over time, air is gonna get released somehow by walking on them so much, by getting little holes in them. So they're just not worth it for me. Because the midsole has air inside, it does mean it's really squishy, but it is really thick. So that's a good thing about it. It is durable. They are priced at £450, so due to the recent price increase of the normal Alexander McQueens, which have gone to £390, they're £60 more expensive. And it's not a massive jump, it's probably just because they cost more to produce. So they're still in like the same price range, so I don't reckon the price of them would put you off buying them. Because let's be honest, Alexander McQueen aren't going to bring out, or any designer brand for that matter, aren't going to bring out a 2.0, an extended version, and make it cheaper. They are going to make it more expensive. But you can kind of justify it because it's new technology. You don't really see this on a shoe, on a designer shoe especially, a full 360 bubble. It is kind of interesting and it's kind of unique to look at, so it kind of catches the eye. If you look closely at this midsole though, because it's a clear one, because it's white, it actually looks to me like, do you know when your windows get condensated and it looks like they're steamed up? With these clear ones, that it looks exactly like that. It makes the midsole look dirty. And I don't like that about it, because who wants to have dirty looking shoes? And the fact you can't even do anything about it because it's inside the bubble. Like, surely they should have come up with something to stop that. They do, however, do a black bubble midsole, which this doesn't happen to because they're black, so you can't see it as much. So if you wanted that not to happen to your shoes, I'd recommend getting those ones. For me, between the OGs and these ones, definitely get the original ones. That has been the Alexander McQueen bubble review. Let me know in the comment section what you think of these ones. Do you prefer these? Do you prefer the old ones? I just don't get why they've done it. Like, really, I don't get it. Let me know in the comment section what you think. Thanks for watching. We'll be back really soon with another review. Remember to hit that subscribe button. Remember to watch the Cassie Thought podcast. And yeah, see you on Wednesday.